across the state of Montana, they're a very thing. At this, probably at this very moment, there's somebody on the stage talking. And this is a great event that we do every year where we combine AA forces, AA bands, to come together and do a concert with a special guest conductor. One of the great things about being a band director that I've learned over the years is that I get to watch the students over many, many years, their progression as people and as musicians. And this is maybe the biggest joy for me. But the flip side of that is, the hard side, is that when they hurt, I hurt. And this past year has been one of those years. These students up here, they've lost so much of what they love in life this past year. For many of them, they lost most of what they did outside of just normal schoolwork. Their concerts, district music festivals, state music festival, all state, you know, they've lost pretty much all that for a year. And so it's very hard as directors to see that and see that in their eyes. But if we flip the side again, it brings an amazing amount of joy to me right now to see them back on the stage, to see this festival back going, and to see them performing again and see the joy in their eyes. So we're really, really happy to be able to perform for you tonight. And we're gonna have two groups, the percussion ensemble and then the mass band, and in between that, we're gonna get some pictures that we'll be able to spread around. And on the percussion ensemble, when we're organizing this, and trying to figure out all the stuff with COVID and how we were gonna arrange it, and who we would have for the percussion ensemble, we realized we have two expert percussionists among our ranks, and Mr. Barr and Mr. Hollow very, very graciously offered to organize this and make it happen, the percussion ensemble, in addition to everything they were doing with these guys on the stage. And so I'm very, very grateful to them, and I'd like to welcome Mr. Barr to the pit, and this is the percussion ensemble.
Recycled by Julie Davila, and they're playing on buckets. And forgive our transitions, we're going to have just a couple. And this next piece was a piece I wrote for a school in Kentucky way back in 1994. And they didn't have any percussion equipment whatsoever, so I wrote this piece as a body percussion piece to get these guys doing a percussion ensemble, something of some sorts. And we were just about ready to perform it, and then their school got hit by a tornado, and we never got to. But the piece exists, and it's been fun to perform in many different places. And so I would like to tribute that little school in Nicholasville, Kentucky, to the composition SOS, which is based on the Morse code, Save Our Ships. As we set up for our last piece here, just wanted to thank our hosts, both Helena and Capital High School, and especially Dwayne for putting this all together. It's quite a huge undertaking to host one of these events. I've had the shared duties of that before, and absolutely very smooth, very great, and it's been fun for my students, and I know the rest of the students here too. And this is also the first time that I've gotten to work at a AA with the students instead of just watching. It's been a blast. These kids behind me have been completely awesome these last 2 days. We have worked many hours, and through fatigue mentally and physically, and they have powered through and are doing a fantastic job. These kind of events are great because most of this music that we're playing tonight, especially this last piece, none of these kids saw before yesterday. I brought this piece with me and I said, okay, you play this part, you play this part, you play this part. And so you're gonna see what 2 solid days of rehearsal can do. I think you'll be rather impressed. And this last piece is called Death by Ooga Booga by Edward Freitag.
Mark? Thank you. Could you push those stands down that are just right there by the stage? Thank you. There are all the snares off.
Now I'd like to extend a few thank yous out there. First, thank you from Mr. Hollow and I to Glacier, the Glacier students and the Glacier directors and Skyview students and Skyview directors for coming all this way and participating with us, even with a major bus breakdown that they suffered for many hours on Monday. We are very privileged to have you here and on our stage. So thank you. Then there's many helpers and chaperones that make these things really happen. I'd like to extend many thank yous to the host families that hosted students tonight. And one of the cool things about this event to me is that the students get to get together and they get to know each other, even if it's for a day. They learn that skill and they get to see each other in a different kind of setting. And so thank you for making that possible. Also, thank you to the people that helped this the past 2 days during the day. Tina Hetley, Carmen Lay, Amber Colby, and also my wife, Dawn Zare, who helped with many things over the past weeks, getting stuff together and going and picking stuff up the last couple days. And also to Mr. Harris, who is back there just taking the pictures and is running the live feed for us tonight so that families can watch this if they're in a different different city. So we're going to get on to the concert band portion. A couple of years ago at convention, as I was quietly and invisibly kind of walking around the convention, I happened to notice our guest conductor tonight. And I got immediately curious that this is the kind of guy that I would like to meet at some point, because after a distinguished long career in the Navy, in the Navy bands, he came to Montana and then immediately inserted himself into the music world here, and by teaching, getting back into teaching, and getting involved with the bandmasters and the convention. And it seemed like to me that this is the kind of guy that I would like to get to know. And also I thought about this event. I thought, man, I'll bet this that he would be great for this type of event. And it proved to be true. And we're very, very grateful that he was able to do this with us and perform with us, or conduct us and do this performance with us. So I'd like to welcome to the stage now, Mr. Patrick Sweeten.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and most especially, thank you, Mr. Duane Zaire. You have created a magnificent festival. We are all indebted to your organization and to your dedication to music education and to these young people on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a solo round of applause for our host, and it is indeed my pleasure to get to know you. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight would not be possible without several people, some of whom have been mentioned already, but I would like to make special note of, in addition to Mr. Zaire, Director of Bands at Capitol High School, Mr. Cody Hollow, Director of Bands at Helena High School, Mr. Go ahead. Mr. Aaron Schneider, Director of Bands at Skyview High School, and his assistant, Mr. John Goodhart. And my great friend, also from Kalispell, Mr. David Barr, Director of Bands at Glacier High School. I especially like to point out that I'm recognizing them because tonight is possible and our great rehearsals that we had yesterday and today, thanks to their very extensive and detailed preparation of these students prior to my getting to work with them. I am just incredibly proud and privileged to stand in front of these young people. We are in great hands in the music world if this is anything like what's going on in the rest of the state. Outstanding, outstanding musicians. Now, as I say, on with the show. Our first selection is by the March King himself, Mr. John Philip Sousa. Household name, during his time, he was independently wealthy. You might say he was the Oprah Winfrey of his day. He wrote over 200 marches and over 500 pieces of music for band, and then over 600 for all different kinds, from orchestra to choirs to band musicals, had a Broadway piece. So when Mr. Zare approached me, and I said, sure, I'd love to do that. This is right down my alley. At the time, as you can read in my bio in your program, but I was just transitioning from the Navy, retiring after nearly 30 years as a Navy bandmaster. What that means is that I was a band director. And I was retiring as the 31st director of the United States Naval Academy Band, located in Annapolis, Maryland. So I immediately went to the one John Philip Sousa piece that connects everything. A little bit of background. John Philip Sousa created what we now call the Navy Music Program in 1917, just 3 years prior to the composition of this piece, which was written in 1920. John Philip Sousa began the Navy Music Program in Great Lakes, Illinois. From my perspective, that's hallowed ground. And I was very blessed to be the bandmaster of that band and sit in the Sousa chair at the Sousa desk in front of the Sousa painting that stared at me every day. And I knew, and yes, we saw his ghost from time to time. And yes, I knew the weight of responsibility. John Philip Sousa retired from the Navy 2 years later, this is during World War I, in 1919 at the rank of Lieutenant Commander, which is the rank that I retired as. I have a personal connection with Sousa. It goes back decades before, and even in my doctoral work at the University of Illinois, where the Sousa archives are housed. So this piece was created in 1920 and dedicated to the class of 1920 at the United States Naval Academy. It's become synonymous with the Naval Academy Band, our very long history. The Naval Academy Band is the third oldest in the United States military and the oldest in the United States Navy. We are very, very proud of that lineage, of that history, and of our connection with this great march with John Philip Sousa, the March King. Ladies and gentlemen, we certainly hope you enjoy our performance of Who's Who in Navy Blue.
Thank you.
you. What a great march that is. It was such a pleasure to do it one more time. Another ride into the sunset, if you will. The next piece is something completely different. Composer's name is David Gillingham. He's an outstanding percussionist, a great educator, and an awesome composer. This piece, Be Thou My Vision, is actually based on two pieces of music. One is the church hymn, Be Thou My Vision, and the other is an old Irish ballad, a slow piece, called Slain. And he just happened to really enjoy both of these pieces, received a commission by the great Ray Kramer from Indiana, from your home state there, Mr. Zare. And Ray Kramer commissioned this for his parents, who are also educators, as kind of a living and lasting testament to their dedication to music ed and to everything good in life. This piece is really just a breath of fresh air. I hope you enjoy this because this piece has so much music packed into its short 4.5-5 minutes of duration. Has a lot of interesting moving lines. There's solos throughout the band. We hope you enjoy Be Thou My Vision.
Thank you.
When Dwayne first contacted me about guest conducting for this great opportunity, he said, you know, COVID's been rough. Maybe we should hold the music down and just get, you know, get them excited again about playing. I said, you know what? Let's raise the bar and see what happens. And I, of course, came with a bunch of tunes just in case some of what we programmed didn't work out. This next selection is one of the top 8 pieces in the professional band repertoire. One of the top 8. Song for Band, written by Vincent Persichetti, who is one of the giants in our field, is a sound painting, if you will. Exceptionally difficult. Like I said, it's from the professional repertoire. This band, from day one, bought into it, and oh my goodness, what a wonderful oral experience that we've had in rehearsals. Not a lot of percussion in this one, but oh my goodness, does it make up for that with percussive effects throughout the band. Lots of features. You will notice that there's saxophones, trombones, French horns, trumpet features as a section, as a little mini choir within that. And this is also based upon the liturgical pieces. So, Song for Band, one of the stalwarts in our repertoire, by Vincent Persichetti.
Thank you.
So proud of these young people. Absolutely outstanding performance in every sense of the word. I've had the honor of conducting, the privilege of conducting honor bands all over the nation, parts of the world. And I can tell you that, and I shared this with the students earlier today and with Mr. Zare, I am so impressed with what's going on here between these four high schools in spite of all the challenges. Oh my gosh, Skyview? I mean, come on. They were getting lunches by moose yesterday at this time. They absolutely have been through the ringer with us the last 2 days, as far as long, lengthy rehearsals, short breaks in between, and they did it all with a smile, at least to our faces. So I'm very, very, very proud of them. And ladies and gentlemen on stage, none of this is possible without the support of your family, your loved ones, your guardians, your parents. How about we give them a thanks? I can tell you that's heartfelt. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your support for music education and for the arts. It is not taken for granted in today's climate of competing budgets and competing activities for your children's time and attention. We, music educators, are the better for your support. Thank you again for that. For our last selection this evening, is a very famous Italian song called Finiculi Finicula. And it was written in the 1850s for a funicular train system, which is, if you've ever been on a system with a counterweight, one train goes down, the other train goes up the mountain. The weight of one train carries the other one up. Still in use today. Thankfully, we have motors, because I don't know that I could be totally dependent on the weight of the people beside me to get up or down the mountain. But it was a big deal in the 1850s. So Luigi Denza wrote a very famous piece. You will recognize the melody right away. It's first performed over in our great trombone section. But this arranger, Yo Goto, a Japanese individual who came to America to study, finished his master's at the great North Texas University, University of North Texas now, excuse me. And this was one of his first projects as a full-time professional composer. It's been almost 20 years now when this piece came out. This is Yo Goto's arrangement of Luigi Denza's song, Finiculi Finicula. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for sharing your children with us yesterday and today. And again, thank you for your support for their music education and for the arts in general. Please drive safely. I hope our paths cross again. Have a wonderful evening.